We need to help local startups grow because these young, innovative companies hold the future and could potentially be among the biggest companies in the Philippines, employing thousands of Filipinos. For example, in the US, IT companies account for around 27% of the S&P 500 index. Moreover, because of their rapid growth, relatively young tech companies such as Amazon, Google, Tesla, and Meta are now among the top 10 biggest companies in the US. However, one of the major challenges facing startups in the Philippines is the lack of external financing. According to the 2020 Startup Report, 78% of startup founders consider funding requirements a major challenge. Moreover, according to a study by Preqin, venture capital investments in the Philippines amounted to only $28.8 million in 2018. In contrast, Singapore and Indonesia were able to raise $4.9 billion and $1 billion respectively from venture capital funds. Nevertheless, local startups' ability to raise funding is improving. In 2019, the Innovative Startup Act was signed into law. This created a Philippine Startup Development Program that provides benefits and incentives for startups, including a startup grant fund for selected companies. The government also passed laws that make it easier for foreign investors to buy shares of local companies and to do business in the country. For example, because of the amendments to the Foreign Investment Act, foreigners can now own SMEs with a minimum capitalization of $100,000, provided that the business utilizes advanced technology, is a startup or a startup enabler, and employs at least 15 Filipinos. Meanwhile, the CREATE law provides generous tax benefits for startups in the tech industry. Finally, the pandemic resulted in the explosive growth of digital payments, e-commerce, and digitization in general, increasing the attractiveness of the local market to tech businesses. For example, according to data from the BSP, the share of digital payments in the total volume of retail transactions jumped to 30.3% in 2021 from 20.1% in 2020. Because of the strong growth momentum, the central bank said it is on track to achieve its goal of digitizing 50% of all retail transactions this year. Meanwhile, e-commerce gross merchandise value in the country increased significantly from only $3 billion US in 2019 to $14 billion in 2022 and is projected to reach $26 billion in 2025. Because of these factors, the amount of funds raised by local startups increased significantly from $152 million US in 2019 to $1.1 billion US in 2022, according to a study by Foxmont Capital and Boston Consulting Group. Hopefully, this trend continues given the favorable changes in regulation and the rapid growth of the local market, helping the Philippines create several unicorns in the future. Before we wrap up the show, we leave you with a quote from Apple co-founder Steve Jobs. Innovation distinguishes between a leader and a follower.